Tonight, state leaders say they've tracked down the murderer who disappeared after former Governor Barber gave him a pardon.
Agents from the AG's office say they found Joseph Ozment 1,400 miles away in Wyoming. They claim the former trustee even tried to run when he saw the agents coming. The AG claims Ozment has been with a woman since his pardon. Now he's questioning how they got to know each other while he was supposed to be in the governor's mansion. 16 WABT Scott Simmons is live. And Scott, what can you tell us about some pictures that just popped up?
Well, it's interesting, you know, they found Ozment. Today we found out that he was planning a wedding. His wife, or fiance, I should say, an engineer who may have had as many as 15 visits with Ozment while he was a trustee here at the governor's mansion.
Attorney General Jim Hood says his agents did serve Joseph Ozment with a notice to be in court Friday.
He was driving his girlfriend's Mercedes vehicle, attempted to flee.
Ozment was the only one of five Governor's Mansion trustees who did not check in after the Parting Gate controversy. This is Joseph Ozment and his fiancée, LaChyna Tillman. A wedding announcement for March revealed photos taken at the Governor's Mansion. Ozment is wearing street clothes. According to the AG, Tillman works as an engineer for Northrop Grumman. He says Tillman visited Ozment as many as 15 times in 1 year while he was a trustee, working and living on the governor's mansion grounds.
Some of this activity at the mansion is really disconcerting as to the freedoms these people had, you know, dressing in street clothes and having visits. I don't know if they were conjugal visits or what they actually had there at the mansion.
Hood also fired back at claims made by Haley Barber that the attorneys with the AG's office advised him how to handle pardons. Hood showed these emails from his attorney to the governor's advisor, Daryl Neely, the same man I tried to talk to last week about the same thing.
You're the governor's policy guy. We haven't heard from the governor's people on this matter.
I can't make a comment on it until February 3rd.
No comment?
No comment.
November 28th, David Scott from the AG's office advised Neely to look at the Constitution and the part about needing 30 days notice before granting pardons. According to Hood, Neely said the governor didn't need publication. It wasn't until January 6th Neely notified MDOC to place the notices in the newspapers. Definitely not enough time to meet the 30-day requirement. Hood says he wants to charge Governor Barber a bill for what the state is spending on this pardon fight.
All this expense that has been incurred in tracking down and sending investigators to Wyoming, putting our guys in danger, putting the citizens of the United States in danger, Governor Barber is going to have to pay one day for all these expenses that he's caused us to incur.
And late this evening, I received a statement from Haley Barber's spokesperson, Laura Hipp. She points out MDOC policy states that minimum security inmates, like the trustees here at the governor's mansion, were allowed to have visits from family and friends. She points out on the weekend, they were allowed to wear street clothes. She says they were under guard the whole time and there were no conjugal visits. Live at the governor's mansion, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.
Yeah, Scott, before I let you go, what about the attorneys for the other trustees? What's his reaction to the Hood news?
Yeah, I talked to Tom Fortner today. He filed a motion with the state Supreme Court, in essence saying that that's where this case belongs. He says the governor's pardon power is exclusive. It is worth noting, though, that part about 30 days notice was placed in the state constitution in 1890. Back to you.
Wow. All right. Scott Simmons live. Thank you.
All right. Well, here's a recap of what happened today in the Pardon Gate saga. Attorney General Jim Hood says agents from his office found Joseph Ozment more than 1,400 miles away in Laramie, Wyoming. The agents served him with a court order to check in every 24 hours to MDOC. He has to be back in Jackson for a Friday court date. At that time, Judge Tommy Green could decide to revoke his pardon along with nine others.